Welcome to the Jane Friends Podcast.
It's he wearing like his Puma.
That part. Like crazy. Whoa, yo, 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 yo. Welcome to the JFP. We are down one. It's just Jay now. Taya's under the weather, so shout out to you, fam. Prayers, thoughts, and positive vibrations. Hope you feel better.
That nigga just trying to watch the draft.
I know it. You said it. I didn't. You said it. I didn't, brother.
Lamar get some money now. And these motherfuckers
take the day off. Take the day off. Call in. Damn, this close to no call, no show.
Yeah. Sound like one of my drivers.
Yeah. Listen, this is episode. I'm gonna pull it up because we ain't got the screen today. This is episode 174. Man, how you doing, dog? How was your week?
Cool, man. Been busy, still transitioning to the new position.
Is it official yet?
Nope, not yet. Probably after next week. After
percentage, like what, 85? You like wrapping up the contract work? About 85% complete?
75.
75?
Oh, 75.
I bet. Who fucks with it? Too loud? You too loud?
No, I'm good.
I bet. All right, man, listen. A lot of shit to get to. We have the NFL draft going on in the background, the lights, Nell is enjoying the new mic stand. He's not holding the mic like Arsenio Hall this week. Yeah. So before we get started, man, let's open up the podcast like this. Just because, you know what I'm saying, I'm with my guy. Turn the radios up. Favorite Potters are here. Them maters keep talking. All them other Potters. It's for y'all. Seen no waitress.
Tell her bring more liquor.
Tell her bring more liquor.
Homer dolls in the building. And we smoking on that killer. Anybody know a hater? Middle finger to the ceiling.
All up.
Feeling like John got it. Can't nobody fuck with us. We them niggas. We them niggas. We them niggas. All them bad bitches know it. We them niggas. We them niggas. Middle finger to the ceiling. We them niggas. We them niggas. We don't really give a fuck. We them niggas. We them niggas.
Welcome to the
screaming fuck them other niggas cause I'm down for my niggas. Middle finger to the ceiling, everybody keep calm cause you got some real niggas in the building. And you don't really look familiar, that's your girl. My bad in my ear, she been begging me to hit her. Oh lord, have her really catching feelings all night from the club to the villa. Know you chilling with the realest, I ain't even gotta say it. Blowing money, you don't really mean a litter. We them niggas from the bottom to the top. Y'all mad, LOL, go figure. Ball main on the feet, 20 bottles of the peach on the way, light 'em up, light 'em up. I don't really give a what, I don't really give a what. Mess around, I'm about a whole club. I'm just really showing love, they gon' probably get a mad. So sad, all haters need a hug. Take a hit of these drawers, getting high with my dogs till the motherfucking sun come up. Let it pass, puff, puff. Anybody seen a waitress? Waitress. Tell her bring more.
Welcome to the Jam Friends Podcast, episode 174. We are here. I'm here to give you an hour. We're going to give you an hour of good shit. You're here. My week was good. It was slow, ready to pod. The NFL draft is going on. We lost a lot of lives this week. It really cooled down. It cooled down in the DMV this week. It was a little warmer than I would like it.
That shit went from 90 last Friday.
To in the low 60s. It did like... It doesn't matter, like 40 something.
Back wearing hoodies and shit.
Stay woke.
Last part, I was ready to put the dad.
Yeah, the leather bag. Ready to bring leather bands out.
I'm about to bring them out. Damn.
Yes, sir. So, let's get to it. Let's go to my phone. Let's get to it. All right. Joe Biden. Real quick. Before I get started, I want to send a shout out to those that wear the uniform, those that wore the uniform, those that wear the uniform in the future. Shout out to those that hang in the VA all day. Shout out to the United States of Baltimore. Zone 18 and the rest of the DMV. I want also like, share, comment, subscribe on YouTube. Follow us on all social media platforms. It costs you nothing and it goes a long way. Without y'all, there is no us. We love bringing you content. And and any question or topic you want us to talk about, DM any one of us and we got you.
Yep.
Very special shout out to Watch My Sneakers, yeah. My man Jay.
Shout out to Jay. Jay always showing love.
Jerry, Tara Boynton, who do our nigga count.
I started off straight off the brick one.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sitting in Tay's seat, so I gotta keep it going.
All right. Biden announces run for re-election, man. We knew it was coming. I thought they was holding off because maybe he wouldn't, but he announced it. What you got?
Man, I'm good on Sleepy Joe. And I mean, I know this is a place, I mean, I normally don't talk politics, but I mean, of course, here we talk. But like, I mean, I didn't vote for Sleepy Joe and his foolishness at the first go. So I definitely wouldn't be voting for him now. I'm like, I'm good on Joe.
I voted for Sleepy Joe. I let the cat out of the bag. At that moment in time, it was anything but Trump. And it wasn't about, to me, it got to the point where it was beyond his policies and antics. It was just, I really was voting for 4 years of quietness, and that's what we got.
For sure.
Every time you turn on the TV, it's always something. He's lying. He's saying something wild and crazy. I didn't say that. Then they run it back. I didn't say that.
My man was blocked from social media and everything.
Everything. So it was like, all right, cool. But we also see what happened when you choose the, you know, you got two evils and you choose the lesser two evils, and we got a dude that, shit, he fall asleep mid-sentence, and you got a vice president that she called on black women, and y'all wore y'all chucks and pearls right after that election, and what she do for you?
Nothing.
I ain't seen but three pictures of her ass in the whole damn term. Three. And I see her, they helicopter and plane fly through here all the time.
All the time.
All the time.
Yeah.
So, you know, Biden, good luck, brother. Good luck. Whatever you, I don't know what you're campaigning on, because you obviously didn't do shit this time.
No.
Now you fucking us up with these tax shit. Now we're going to get to you on these housing rates later. But, you know, I said it before, I said it again, when I was in the military, I always voted Republican, because Republicans are pro-defense spending. And that was the better thing for me when I was in uniform. So now I kind of get into the nuances and the weeds of what they running on. And, you know, again, anything at this point, we already know the Republicans got it in the bag. So it's a matter of, it's going to be DeSantis, Trump, Big T, or some outlier.
Big T not getting back in there.
Dog.
I'm with the shit, but I don't think. My man,
I don't know, dog. His numbers looking, boy. Listen, they love him. They love him some Big T, boy.
I mean, hey, he came through with the come through when, yo, Harford County. I mean, they were, that was Trump.
He killed it. Yeah, I remember
Trump
that. He
killed town on Harford County. I'm riding through there like, yo.
And wasn't it right around that time they had just had that, like that mass shooting not too long after, before that. Remember that?
Mm-mm.
It was a mass shooting in Harford County at a warehouse.
Yes.
And then he campaigned right. Yes. Like, it was a little bit after that. I was like, oh, he riling him up.
Was it? I don't know, it was one, but it was at a warehouse. Yep, I remember. Yo left. Left, work came back.
He riled him up. So, mm-hmm. And again, good luck. And you know, may the best person win. All right. The Biden administration plans to raise payments for good credit homebuyers. If you have a credit score of 740 plus, you will pay an extra 1% on your mortgage. Those with 620 or less will get a 1.75% decrease.
That's foolish. Why? Like, you work hard to get to this position because they always tell you credit. Credit is going to give you the best option. It's going to give you the lower rate. Credit. So that's what I've been doing. I've been building my credit, and like, I'm at 788. Like, I was at like 790 something before my credit got destroyed. And then I had to build it back to where it is at now. Cause I mean, I want a lower rate. Plus I'm in the business of looking for a house. So this goes against me because this is what this is all we've known forever, is to get a good credit score and you'll get a better interest rate.
I've read about it and I still don't understand what the purpose of, other than, okay, the obvious, you want to encourage home buying. Mm. I mean, they got programs for that, because you talking about somebody with a, what I just said, a 620 or less credit score. I think the minimum credit score you got to hop by for like a whatever they call it, like the little government funded, I think it's like a 540. When you at that level, and I don't want to be, like talking about like blanket, like this blanket statement, but it is a blanket statement. Like, those are the type of people that be like, okay, my credit is a 540 or 550 or 580. I'm ready to buy a house. And you don't even understand that you need closing money. Mm-hmm. And you can't borrow money because when you do all of that, it messes up your credit because, you know, you're pulling. And so I don't understand it. Again, the broad pitch is you want to increase home ownership in America. You want to encourage people to buy homes. Right now, first off, it ain't a buyer's market.
Not at, what?
It's a seller's market.
Bro, I'll be on Redfin and I'll be like, yo, they want 480 for this. What I mean.
This is safe space?
Very.
All right, I'm low-key hoping for a recession to come, boy. I swear to God, I want it to come because if they do, I'm buying another car and I'm getting another crib.
Yeah, when I got the Denali, I was so upset because the dude was like, man, even though I still got a great rate, I got 2% interest. But he was like, man, if you would have came in a couple months ago, shit was 0%.
She.
I was like, what?
Zero?
Zero.
Good God almighty. Zero. Jeez.
Yeah, so I wouldn't be mad if a recession came through. I mean,
I don't want it to affect nothing, me, but like this,
crazy.
I need to reset. We need the house market to reset because it is wild. It's wild. The housing market is wild.
Well, if this new COVID shit come strong.
I don't even see it. At this point, man, they done cut the COVID with baking soda about 18 times over. That COVID don't hit like it did in 19.
I literally asked a coworker. I'm like, yo, because I was telling him a story about something. I'm like, yo, is COVID still a real thing? Is it still a thing? He's like, hell yeah. I'm like, oh, all right. I just wanted to.
It is, because I was in a meeting today and they was arguing about like, if you don't need to come in a building, don't come in a building. And they have just went to reduce maintenance, so reduce cleaning bathrooms, reduce kitchen staff and all of this stuff. So like, they basically like kind of took the building we had, if this square was a building, and then they just cut it in half, made everything dead, and now it's called hoteling. So you don't have a dedicated office. Like, and if you got to come in, you got to send an email and say, hey, I need to come in for this, this, and this, and this, and this, and this, and this. And they say, okay, here's where you can go sit. But even then, it's still problems because people, it'd be old people. They just want to go to work every day.
Yes.
And then it's like, yeah, well, you didn't even send an email requesting authorization to come, and we got our cap of folks, and you fucking us up. But so we dealing with that. But I don't know, man. The housing thing, I just don't get it. Like, for people of color, anyway, you. Your mama probably put a phone in your name, some other shit. Then when you do figure the shit out, then you go to college or you just do some early shit, you get a bunch of credit cards, they start sending shit to you in the mail, you fuck your credit up. Mm-hmm. It's easy to fix it. Just whatever, wait a little 7 years. So here we are, damn near 30. Now it's time to make good decisions.
Right.
Shit done fell off. And now you telling me that I worked hard to get 740, 790, 810, 800. And you telling me somebody with a fucking... a 640 can get a better rate than me with an 810. Come, boy, yep. Don't play with me.
It's crazy. I don't
Stop
understand.
Stop playing with me.
I don't understand.
And y'all wonder why they trying to make these little packs to make the dollar go down.
Yo, I mean, and it's with anything, because, I mean, being on Eastern Avenue, that shit is like, I mean, no disrespect, but the shit is like Little Mexico now. Like, Eastern Avenue went through their phases, though. Like,
yeah,
when I was young, it was a lot of white people. Then as I got older, a lot of black people. Now, that shit is Little Mexico from top to bottom until you get downtown, the whole Eastern Avenue.
Mm.
And everybody, temp tags, riding pickup trucks, brand new whips. She's sitting so close to the goddamn steering wheel, can't even fucking turn. 4 feet, nothing. And, yo, they giving her whips like it's nothing. And that's insane, too. Like, yo, how did they get to walk in, get whips? The rates are easy, but for us regular folk, nope.
Crazy.
Charge it to the game.
To the game, dog. I would love to. I can't wait for Tay to come back. I want to hear his thoughts on this housing thing. Like, it's just, yeah.
No, yo, it's just stupid, yo, man. I'm telling you, man. Jimmy be up just browsing. And it's just ridiculous in certain places. Like, bro, this shit don't even have Like nothing new, like nothing upgraded, and they want.
And they know they could mark that shit up 50,000 more than what it's worth. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Because I'm look, I need 4 bedrooms. So,
boy, what are you looking at?
I've been looking everywhere, bro. Like, I want to move.
I know you work at, and I know where she work at. So, are y'all moving further south? Y'all looking south?
No, if it was me, we'd be moving further. We'd be moving west because we in Perry Hall now. So we'd be moving west, basically closer to my job, but it's not far from her. Because when I live west,
like Columbia,
she could commute to work quicker. Columbia High is.
I know, but you're going like a little west of Columbia?
Yeah, like Randallstown.
You ain't looked delayed. Laurel?
Nah, I mean, I would. That's too far for her. That commute is too far for her.
Laurel too far? Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because she actually works on Eastern Avenue also.
Oh, shit, okay.
That's too far a commute for her. Mm. So you want to stay in a range. And like her parents like drive, so we try to stay and give so they can drive in a driving area.
Yeah. What about in Harford County? Nah. Over so Harford County, I mean, cut you off. You got two things against you. First off, it's a bad market, and you got military. You fighting with them.
Yeah, but they be in and out. I mean, because my mom has lived in Harford County now for like 20, like she's like 20 years in. So I've seen the military people come in, come and go. Like it was a cool ass couple that worked. They moved in when my mom moved in. They was there for a few years. Like, shit, we out. And they was getting stationed somewhere else, and they like, yeah, we selling the crib, we gone. They was cool as shit. Like, hey, it was cool as a motherfucker. But hey, it is what it is.
Damn. All right. What we got? What we got? What we got? RP to Harry Belafonte. Harry Belafonte.
Damn, I didn't see that.
Yeah, Harry Belafonte. This wasn't a day. He'd been died, but Harry Belafonte. Oh, no, I just added it.
I'm so sorry.
I just added it. Harry Belafonte is a singer. Actor, he's a renaissance man of many talents, and he just recently died. So condolences and prayers and positive vibrations to his family and all those affected. Harry Belafonte, he has passed. Also, RIP to Jerry Springer.
Man.
21 gun salute to my guy. I gotta hook my phone up because Jerry dropped gems on us, man. Like Jerry is a staple in white, black, poor white trash communities.
There was a time where you were leaving, trying to leave school.
Yes, sir. Get home.
To get home. I think when Jerry came on, 3 o'clock.
Yes, sir.
To make sure you caught that fight because it was some ass whippings going down.
Yes, sir.
At 3 o'clock.
What was it? Was it?
Shit. Anthony Richardson just went to the Colts.
Went to the Colts, dog. Went to the Colts. Let me see. Jerry Springer, though. A lot of people don't know is I think Jerry Springer was a Democratic politician, and I want to say I'm almost certain he was the mayor of Cincinnati.
Really?
Hell yeah, he was a damn good politician. He was a damn good politician. Huh. He was a mayor of Cincinnati. Let me see if I can find it real quick.
Yo, some of the topics that used to be on Jerry's show was fucking.
Well, it started off all right. It started off all right.
I mean, he did get outlandish with the shit. I mean, it just went over the top at one point, especially after they had to take the fighting off. Like, all right, they told him no more fighting.
Then Steve Wilco just carried the torch.
Then Steve moved on. But like that was crazy because like Steve went from being like the bodyguard breakup guy. My man Steve had his own serious ass
crazy
talk show.
And I'm like, Steve Wilco.
The Steve Wilco show.
Like what? But I'm trying to find
But no, Jerry had some crazy ass topic. My I'm pregnant by my sister's husband's and we're having twins and like yo, these should be crazy.
That part.
It's crazy.
Oh, I'm trying to find.
You supposed to have the Jerry Trent come on. Jerry.
No, I'm trying to find it. I'm trying to find the it was a post where they had a bunch of shit with like how he do his little closing thoughts.
Yeah.
But I can't seem to find it on
the people and got their ass whipped and then he come with the serious.
He hit you with like a good one of them J closing thoughts like salt and sugar is the same, so don't trust nobody. And like they were doing shit like that, but I'm trying to find it real quick.
Was he 89 years old?
Yeah, about 89, dog. He
Fucking cancer.
Damn, I can't fuck. Oh, I can't find it.
Cancer is insane.
Yeah, I can't find it. But we could just move on from that. I don't really want to hold us up. All right, last one for deaths. Emmett Till, accuser Carolyn Bryant, Donahue. She passes away at 8-8 due to cancer battle. I'll let you go first for fucking disrespect the dead.
Yeah, I mean, Twitter was going off. I mean, I couldn't help but to laugh. But, I mean, we all know the story of Emmett Till. It's a fucked up thing. That man lost his life. That boy, that young boy, lost his life over a lie. And basically, I mean, they tried to retry her.
The outpour was saying they wanted to retry her. The district attorney was like, we don't have enough evidence. It was like, dog, she said herself she lied.
Yeah.
And I think it was just one of those things where it's just like white privilege.
Yeah.
But I found the Jerry Springer thing. So let me turn my phone up.
What we got?
Here we go.
I mean, how dare this person who so occupied my life and heart leave for somebody else? It's a theft, a personal assault, too much for our ego. And we lash out at who we lost and the person who took him or her. Now, I'm not suggesting it's easy to refrain from such feelings, but we have to know, as bad as those feelings are, it's in our own control as to how long we harbor them. The truth is, we don't want that person back. I mean, who wants to be in a relationship with someone who doesn't love you? Why are we fighting to get this person back? It may have once been good, but it isn't anymore. No, don't let this person continue to hurt you. Let it go. Find someone who will love you back.
Come on, Jerry.
You can have the happiness you want and deserve. As for the lover you lost, you don't love him. You only loved who you thought he was. You're better off moving on. Till next time, take care of yourself and each other.
Hey, man, Jerry.
I'm to get our Jerry B.
They show a titty, boy.
I'm twice the woman you are.
Says a midget.
Let me tell you, you know what? Let me stoop down to your level and talk to you.
Okay. And, well, I decided that I would find another lover. And I...
You're crazy. And hey, look, don't be calling me crazy, right? Because I'm not crazy. I hate when people call me crazy.
This is what the Wayans brothers on the Jerry Springer show.
They was on the Wayans? I ain't know that. I ain't know that.
Hey, Jimmy, tell him stop calling me crazy before I go crazy.
Sean, please refrain from calling him
crazy. You're crazy.
Crazy. All right, anyway, let's get back to it. Oh, man. My man, Don Lemon. Don Lemon. He was fired from CNN after 17 years. 17 years.
I mean, I ain't tripping on it. I mean, I don't.
Don Lemon held us down. Don Lemon and Chris Cuomo held us down on the most boringest news channel of all time during COVID. And now I support us, but I can see why they fired the nigga. That's one, two. I can see why they fired the nigga. That's three. He did some wild shit. So he had an interview with us. I don't remember who. It was a woman a week. So it was like, yo, come to the Jan Fritz podcast on Thursday. So he comes to the podcast, whatever, and he talks about a chick that he's interviewing a week from Thursday. So it's like, oh, this bitch, that. And I'm like, yo, she's coming to see you in a week, dog. And she is going to watch this because this is not just no little platform.
Right.
Then on top of that, like, first off, I forgot to say this. You going drunk Don Lemon on motherfucking New Year's Eve is amazing.
Oh yeah, I forgot he was
drunk Don Lemon on New Year's Eve.
Not
you
last
take
year,
that from
year
us. Yes, you taking yeah. that from me? I forgot who was drunk this
well,
year.
Not this year, but last year. He was.
I forgot who was whatever. But you gonna take
it was him. What was the lady name? Fuck,
I don't know. But
I can't, but yeah,
Don was lit.
They were
he was litty. Lit. You know what I'm saying?
He was cussing on live TV and everything.
Yeah, I know the FCC like got him. Got him. But you took him away, and then he did some other questionable stuff. They was like, oh, he was fucking with interns and like, nah, whatever. But they say they fired him for the morality clause, which is so broad. It's very broad because Morale? You got to define like morality to me. Like what can and I can't do?
They ain't like working with his motherfucking ass. That's all. When he come in that bitch, he hey, that right there, they took that breath every time. That breath right there. Every time he walked in the building, walked in the room, they took that breath right there. They're this like, motherfucker.
This, no, this nigga.
Yeah, that one, but I ain't want to say it. Keep my counter yeah, keep my counter low.
So he's done some questionable stuff, but at the
and
same
then who was old boy he was going back and forth with? He's supposed to be a presidential candidate or some shit? That he was going back and forth like
no,
the
so
NRA.
So he did that.
Freed slaves.
So he shit. Did. So he cost CNN about almost a billion. He talked shit about the company that when they did that runoff in Ohio, the company that made the voting machines, he badmouthed them. So they sued him. And somebody else, and he cost him like $750 million. Mm. But you can't tell me that Don Lemon and Chris Cuomo was bringing people in. So, you know, it's one of them things was like, I've seen worse. Bill O'Reilly, worse. Way worse.
Way worse.
Way worse. What's the other dude? The other white dude, super racist. Fat dude. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I know you're talking about.
He looked like he looked like Bret the Hitman Hart daddy. Like, yeah. God bless his dad. But he looked like Bret the Hitman Hart daddy. And it ain't Bill O'Reilly, but and with the crazy part is I think that's the 10 or 20 anniversary where Cameron told him pause. Why you mad? Why you mad?
You mad?
Yeah, that I seen that online. It was like 10th anniversary. You mad? And Cam talked about it. But yeah, man. Shout out to Don Lemon though. I know since I brought up Cam, have you watched the Cam and Mace TV show is getting a lot of like attention, and they saying that bit. The shit is good. They said it's good, but
Cam Teeth. I can't.
Well, no, Brandon Marshall's co-host on one of his other shows kept saying, it's a good show, but every other word they say is pause. And it's just, it takes away from what they're saying. So it's like,
I'm sure Cam is pause fucking crazy. But is Cam teeth, yo? He's still not used to his teeth?
He got new teeth?
Yeah, he got new teeth.
He got them jewels? That shit.
Nah, that's just...
Yo, he don't even rap the same.
Nah, neither does Cam. Cam, like, he struggles to talk.
Mm.
His whole jawline is different. Fuck with them big ass...
He got the top center bottom?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you can't.
Yeah.
No,
his shit different. So, I don't know. But I've seen it on Twitter a couple... inserts of it. I'll check it out, but I've never watched a full show of it. I can't listen to those two for an hour, however long the show is. I couldn't.
Yeah, I don't even know what it's on. But yeah, shout out to y'all in your show. I hear good things, but I also hear it's pause every other sentence from
probably so.
Cam.
But, Jim Jones said, "Fuck Mace."
I seen that Breakfast Club interview too. Yeah. He no, what he said was, "I can't hate." Something. He said, "I don't really mess with Mace. He need to pray for him.
Go pray or some shit." Yeah. And then Cam shot back and said, "People who say there's no hate, be hating."
Yeah. It's hate. It was hate. Just say this hate. Just say it's hate. I don't fuck with y'all. But
crazy thing. Mace taught Jim how to rap, but hey,
for real?
Yes.
That's on record.
On record.
Where you find that at?
Jim Jones said it. Mace taught him how to rap. He didn't know how to rap. 100% facts.
What?
100% facts.
This
is a Snapple fact that Mace
crazy
showed Jim Jones how to rap. Yes. Snapple fact from now.
Crazy. Mm-hmm. You gonna hate? Man, never bite the hand that feeds
you. Bro, I'm the reason why you getting money now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Is Mace in your top 50?
Top 50.
Ooh, remember I already said 12 slots go to OGs and just older niggas who just of stature. So your top, really top 38. Is Mace in your top 38?
No, not enough body of work. It's not.
Do you keep that same shit for Big? Big is not top 10 because he don't have enough body work. That's why I rank Tupac above him.
I don't keep that with Big. Big okay. Different. But Mace, I mean, that's fucking, I mean, Harlem World. Yo, Harlem World was that. I mean, he's okay, a lot of people's favorite rapper.
Nigga, but, number five. You're not going to do this. How is Big different, bro? Now we potting. How is Big different?
I mean, he really gave you two great albums. He gave you two great albums. He did. Two great.
So he Frank Ocean us.
Where the fuck is Frank? But where the fuck is Frank? Channel Orange was my shit.
Blonde was hard. Like he got Frank got some slaps.
Oh, he do.
And we ain't even talk. I ain't even want to talk about it because I'm an R&B guy. Y'all really not, but he fucked Coachella up.
Oh no, I fucks with the R&B.
They spent $3 million.
I don't trap to death, yo. I know I trap hard, but.
I know. I don't want to put my R&B on
y'all. No, I mixed that shit in. No.
I kind of thought so when you was like, you said something about my playlist. When I said, I'm going to listen to that
I mixed it in. But I don't hold Big to the same thing. Like Big is one of the greatest.
I mean, Big just, is what, top 10?
He in my top 10.
Shit.
He's definitely in my top 10.
He in the top 20, lower 20, yeah. Like 15 to 20.
Fuck no, he's in my top 10. No, Mace is not in my top 50 though.
Wow.
Why? Come all you want to, run all you want to, girl I wanna punch you.
He penned a lot of shit too. He was Drake Ghost. He was how Drake like wrote, I'm ready for fucking Alicia Keys. He was penning a lot of shit behind the scenes that he didn't get paid for.
That's cool.
Now, if you go to title, you see his name in the credits, which is why his gripe was with Puff about my money. But if you look at Mace, if you go to title, look at, type the nigga name in and then put hit the playlist of written shit, he got a lot of shit.
I'm sure Mason done wrote a lot of shit, but.
Mason Bethel, boy, he got a lot of shit.
But not top 50. I'm gonna have to write that shit down one day. Go through my top 100. He in my top 100, but he ain't in my 50.
I think that's how we're gonna close our summer out. When the fall come and it started to get cool, we're gonna end this year with some our top 50 rap list. And we got to bring a big whiteboard too. Like we got to, cause a lot of us the same. So I want to just see like where it differs. Like you know you got your Scarfaces, your Jay-Z.
Like it's gonna differ there because like you got Brad High. I have Brad in my list, but you have Brad. Well, you have Brad in like top five, right?
No, I got Brad number one.
Number one. See, I don't have.
But see, I think where our difference is I think.
Of course, like Chase said, it's going to be our demographic.
I went through 15 might be the same. Just the draft order is different. I think once you get to about 15 is where the taper off starts. And then it's like, okay, I might like Ludacris. Somebody might like Mr. Cheeks. Somebody might like.
But I have like Busta Rhymes high.
I don't. But, you know, give me a Busta Rhymes Eminem versus, baby. I'll take it all day.
I can deal with it.
Another one that we didn't make the list, Swiss Beats was on
Breakfast Club,
and he said that, well, he hinted, he didn't confirm Nicki Minaj, Lil Kim versus.
Yo, he said something slick. What the fuck he said?
So, they talked about the 50 and Wayne. He said he couldn't see it. He said he couldn't see it.
But no, he said something about like, my life is on vacation and then I work. Something slick. He said some shit like that. Like, they asked him like, you don't really be working like this. No, I live on vacation and then I go to work. Something slick shit he said about that.
They go way over niggas.
But yeah. I mean, just like Envy said, like, yo, he lives somewhere on the side of a fucking mountain, yo. Mm-hmm. Like, his money is different.
That was supposed to be our guy. That was supposed to be the Jets guy. It's okay, though. It's all right. We're going to be all right. That's a pet peeve of mine, too.
What's that?
Dudes that wear their chains outside, they suit. Dog, you got many, millions other times to wear your chain outside your suit. Today is about elegance.
No, that's how I feel about like mock necks or turtlenecks, and like the chain hangs like funny.
It's just it don't look right. It's about elegance. And like when you got your street clothes on, cool, let your chains hang. But
yeah, chain don't hang right. I got my chain fixed. Jimmy gonna kill me.
Yeah, but anyway, yeah. Let's get to it. What do we got? Okay. Starting next year, 2023, 23 of Georgia's 26 public universities won't need SAT or ACT college tests to apply. The tests will remain required at the University of Georgia, Georgia Tech, and Georgia State.
So the main school, basically the main.
Those are private schools. They're the private top, schools. But they're private schools.
Georgia Tech is a private school. I didn't know Georgia was.
Little known point. I was supposed to go to Georgia Tech for college, part scholarship of football.
Really?
Yep. Yeah, I wanted to be an architect or engineer. I, at that point, I didn't know, but I wanted to go to Georgia Tech. You couldn't tell me Georgia Tech wasn't shit. Did not know it was in Atlanta until they recruited me, but yeah, it's in North Atlanta, though.
Oh, okay. But, what year was that? What year did you been?
I graduated 2000, so they started recruiting me in 98.
Oh, okay.
But yeah.
Yeah, I graduated 2000, too.
Drug-free class 2000.
2000, the Jet. What the fuck? I clash.
Deuce Triple O.
We was the Jetsons, the little class shit.
But yeah, you know, I found this online and I'm reading, and you know, as people's like, well, what was the ACT and SAT created for? And you get down to shit, and it's like some white dude created this test saying that people of color weren't good test takers. This is all this shit, and again, it's a test. And then a lot of black teachers chimed in and was like, hey, even though it's not required, I still would encourage my students to take it because it doesn't hurt to, especially if you make a good score, to add it with your application.
That's not about right.
You know what I'm saying? So she was like, yeah, I get what y'all saying, but I still want to encourage my students to take it and add it with the application because it just only just makes you look that much better when you're applying to a school because they only take so many people a year anyway.
Right. I mean, so, some people aren't good test takers. Yeah.
And, you know, like, I don't know, like, I've seen people in the military, like, they didn't take the SAT or the ACT. So when it comes time to, you know, you're 25, 26. It's like, oh, man, I want to go to college. Well, you're discouraged where they say, well, you have SAT or ACT scores? You're like, nah, I just want to go to college. Like, I want to better myself. And they're like, well, you can't go here because you don't have that. That is a discouraging thing for somebody who, you know, they wants to go to a you know, it ain't like you going to an MIT, you right. know what I'm saying, a Harvard. Like, they just applying to a college and they want to go to school. Are you telling them no? Like, that's, to me, that's stupid as fuck.
That's just like the Wonderlic scores. In football, like, bro, this shit doesn't mean anything.
No, they went away from that.
They did.
They got another one, though.
Because they started being really culturally biased.
Nah, they got another score. Shit. It's another test that is rapid fire, right? Basically, but the way the test is regular stuff. Like, they're just like a bunch of shapes and colors and stuff. And they want, and I don't know who made it, but basically what the test does determine how fast you can read and react and adapt to change. So if you know, like, mid season, the offensive coordinator gets fired, and we bring in another dude, and he changes the whole thing up. How fast can you pick this up? Or if you get traded, how fast can you pick this up? And they said the number one boy scored damn near perfect.
Oh yeah, he said he like fuck that. Like, I'm a football player. Like.
They said he was off the charts with, they was like, they've never seen nobody take this.
I mean, clean.
None of the white boys. Put the goddamn chain in, man. Golly. Who is that? He looked like a cornerback, too. Mm-hmm. Oh, pretty ass.
Yo, pause. I used to hate the, I always hated the questions, yo, were the ones like, Jay catches the train at 1:45. Peter catches it at 6:15.
No. It say Jay catches the train from Miami going to New York at 1:45.
Yes.
Darnell catches the train from Atlanta at 3:45 going to New York. The total distance is this. Who will arrive?
Yo.
When will they each arrive, or and who will arrive first?
On God, it was eeny, meeny, miny, mo when I had to fucking do that. I ain't even gonna hold you. Like, this shit is useless. I'm not even gonna front. Like, yo, I was that guy, like, eeny, meeny. So, if he hollers, let him go. Any, meeny,
mighty, mo.
B. Fucking B.
Nah, you know, it's me, I was like.
That, bro.
I'd be like, I ain't. I'm busy in here.
Yo, but because I'm like, we too spaced out, so I can't high beam. Yeah, like, what question is he, this motherfucker on? Mm. He on 19. I'm still on 6. Yeah. Shit. Slow down, motherfucker.
Oh, shit.
That's the real, yo, y'all was there. Like, trust me, those dumbass questions, like, I want to know who really had the correct answer. Like, they knew this shit. Like, oh, that's A. Peter be there first.
I did, because I drew it out. I drew it out, and I did the math problem. Because they give you the distance, and you divide the distance by time, and you bust that shit down. But, of course, you spend on too much time on one question.
I've been out of high school for 23 years. Never had to use none of that shit in life.
Yeah. FYI, we're going to nail class reunion and shit. So, huh. I can't wait to see this shit. Because some of his classmates are friends with me on Facebook. I mean, not Facebook, Instagram. So I can't wait to see what the rest of his class look like. Because I seen some of them chicks.
They phone. Ugh. Me. Yeah. Back in the day, though, missiles. Fire. Missiles. Now,
38. The 38 special.
Mm. Sup?
All right. So I am sitting here with the podcast resident fight expert, and I will start off by saying I was fucking wrong. Don't hump me first off. Hold on, because I gotta go to my notes. Let me go to my notes, brother. Cause it is somebody that's gonna kick Tank ass, and I got him in my phone.
There's no one.
It is.
I told y'all last
the boy podcast. That's okay. About a year and a half from now, mark my words. I already talked to Donnie this week. It's a boy by the name of Shakur Stevenson. About a year and a half from now, he's going to kick Tank's ass. No. Don't make me call Donnie. Okay, hold on. You're going to have me call Donnie.
He's not. The young boy, Tank will be 2 years, Tank 28, 29. I think he's 29. 31.
I'm calling. I don't know if he's going to answer. He probably won't.
There you go.
Jay.
Yo, I'm on the pod real quick.
What's up, man?
I just told Nell about a year and a half from now, Shakur Stevenson is going to kick the dog shit out of Tank. He said no.
Nell, what's up, Nell?
What's up, my guy?
Year and a half.
Hey, man, tell me you don't believe that. Say, tell me. I know you roll with the light skinned brother, boy. I know you roll with the light skinned brother. So stay. I know you roll with Tank.
Listen, man. Tank got my heart. I've been following Youngin's career for a long time, man. But I ain't gonna lie. It's gonna be a problem when he got to see Shakur. If they ever make that fight happen, it's going to be a problem.
That shit light work. He don't hit hard enough.
You crazy.
Light work.
Hold on, hit hard enough.
Light work.
You seen that boy record? You seen that boy resume?
Light work.
Youngin ain't ducking no ruck, and his defense is impeccable. He the next closest thing to Floyd is out there.
Yeah, he got that shoulder. He worked with that shoulder, boy.
Till Tank beat on that motherfucker. He beat on that arm. Mm-hmm. He gonna beat on that arm. He can try to do that Philly shell shit. He gonna beat on that arm.
Yeah. You think Tank can beat Floyd?
Be who?
Floyd Mayweather.
No.
You think? Okay, then. If you don't think he can beat Floyd, then he ain't got no chance to beat Floyd. He's cool, but he a younger version. He's ready to go.
No, he's not. Floyd is a different animal. That shit, Floyd. Now, that shit is different. Now, Pretty Boy Floyd, Tank will lose. Money Mayweather, Tank will whip that ass. Pretty Boy Floyd, though, yo, listen, Tank will have a serious problem
I ain't give him no drugs. He just had some Costco pizza, so I don't know what he's on right now.
Hey, dog, you is tripping over there right now.
Everybody's running around talking about this Ryan Garcia guy was going to do something to Tank. I don't know what he's supposed to do to him, but they said he's going to do something to him.
Ever since that pod check. Podcast check hit. He been talking crazy.
I mean, I told niggas I had 10,000 on Tank. I was with whatever. I really had 20, but 10 because people would think you cap. You say 20, like, oh, this nigga ain't got 20.
That's how you know you pay niggas too much. $20,000.
I had 10 waiting for anybody to jump out that motherfucker. Nobody want to jump. I paid a couple payments. You know what I mean? Still payments still coming through. That Cash App still ringing.
Okay, Shakur, you know what you know. I was going with Tank too.
Shakur Stevenson, a year and a half from now, he gonna beat the dog shit out of Tank.
We'll see. I mean, you was crazy if you went with like Garcia.
I, you know, I gotta sauce it, dog. Come on, man.
It'll be paying JS.
Yeah, he's tight. Yeah, it's gonna be a good fight, Slim. It's gonna be a real good fight.
No, I hope it happens though. I really hope.
You know he got Devin Haney next up.
Yeah, I want. That's who I want. I want him to get Haney because I need him to get them belts so he can have all the belts. I mean, I believe Haney should beat Loma. I mean,
so y'all are the fight experts. Mm-hmm. In y'all expert opinion, when do you see this fight happening?
Tank and Shakur. That shit.
Between them two.
Yeah,
could be Shakur. Like probably Tank's not next fight because Tank's been fighting 2 years. I mean, twice in a year now. So his next fight will probably be around like November. November. Yeah. It wouldn't be Shakur.
So 24.
Yeah, definitely.
I think they're going to stall it off as like the Pacquiao and Chloe, man. Nobody really, they too good of friends and it's too big of a fight. Like, I don't think they're going to let it happen.
I mean, if they keep talking shit, I don't know who Shakur handlers are, but if they keep talking shit to one another.
So they'll say 24 and you say that you don't think they're going to let it happen?
No, I don't think it'll happen. Best case scenario is 24, but I don't think it's going to happen.
It would be on Shakur's side because that's why Tank got away from Floyd. Y'all need these big money fucking fights. Like, you're not going to keep having me fighting the Rollies and all that shit that's in our camp. No, I need to fight guys out of the camp because that's how I'm going to make all the money.
Gotcha. All right. I appreciate you speaking up, my boy.
He definitely made life-changing money fucking with Garcia with this fucking fight.
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure out who's going to win over there between the three of y'all.
And what?
We ain't even saying.
But I got quiet.
First off, we ain't in the same weight class, but I outshoot all them niggas combined. We not in the same weight class, but I will outshoot them niggas combined.
Oh, y'all ain't in the same weight class.
No.
Okay, you in the gym, huh?
No. These niggas are like butterbean heavyweights, nigga. I'm motherfucking.
You already know. Tay like 6'3 out that motherfucker.
Don't let them talk about y'all like that, dog.
It's all good.
Tay took PTO. Dude. That nigga, he took sick leave, but nigga, nah, I ain't need nigga weight class. Nigga, I'm like junior middleweight, nigga.
I'm like Winky Wright. I'm left-handed, but I fight right-handed. So that power going to be in my jab any fucking way.
The crazy part is...
I fight just like Winky Wright.
The crazy part is, you know what? I am in these niggas' weight class, but I ain't fighting them.
You going to get that...
That's what I was thinking.
All that power, all that power is in my jab, so shit get real, boy.
No, fuck that. If we fight, we going to the octagon, nigga. I need to be able to kick and scoop, nigga.
Oh, Lord.
Man, we fuck with you, daddy. You started shit, man. All right, dog.
Hey, look, man, y'all be safe over there.
My man. Right,
all right, bro. All
right.
But no, man. Shout out to my guy, Tank. He did what he's supposed to do.
Yes, sir.
He broke him down, hit him with a liver shot. You know, you had social media going crazy. Like, oh, he could have got back up. He got back up as soon as he got the 10. He got up. This shit was rigged. Bro, until you get hit in your fucking liver, you will not understand how your body shuts down. I mean, of course, if you... Well, old enough, you'd have knew that's the same way B-Hop beat
Sugar Shane?
No, Oscar.
Oh.
He hit him with a liver shot. And when he hit him, he was like, ah, he's literally screamed, ah, couldn't get up, couldn't breathe.
Mm.
Same thing. Like, yo, getting punched in your fucking, he got punched into his liver and his nose started bleeding.
Dude, but I heard about that, yeah.
But people don't, they just let that go. Like, bro. Yeah. He got hit in his liver and his nose started bleeding. Man, you think he could have got up?
Hell no.
When he got up, he knew Tank saw blood. He was about to hurt him. Yeah. So he did the best thing.
Nah, I'm good. Yeah.
Garcia can fight. I mean, Tank was light years better than him. That's all.
Let me see. We got about 10 minutes before we get out of here.
And one quick, yo, Twitter went crazy because you had motherfuckers on there like, yeah, shout out to Tank, DMV. Y'all know fucking well.
Oh, shit. I'm going to my gunshot.
We are the United States of fucking Baltimore. We ain't no DMV. We ain't no fucking Maryland. We ain't no fucking Oxon Hill and all that shit, man. That boy from Baltimore. So stop all that DMV shit. All
right. R. Kelly or Phil Jackson?
Either or. All
right. Phil Jackson says the Black Lives Matter slogans and logos on the NBA that the NBA publicly embraced during the 2020 bubble year turned him off from professional basketball for good, and he hasn't watched basketball since.
So I tried to listen to the part he didn't really never mention Black Lives Matter. He doesn't mention it. But he mentions, like, I'm sitting there with my grandson, and it says equal opportunity, passes it to love.
And justice
yeah. and layup to...
Well, I mean, you got to laugh. Black Lives Matter because it was on a T-shirt. So if you've seen one, you've seen the other. Didn't say it.
Right, he didn't technically
say it. He insinuated.
But he didn't want to mention it because he was like, yeah, and they had... He wanted to say it that they had that on the baseline of the floor. It was a sticker. That said
they did.
That. Right.
They did.
But he didn't want to say that. I forgot how he worded it. Excuse me. But I forgot how he had worded it, but he didn't really want to say it. But, I mean, we know Phil in his semi-racial ways when he tried to say, like, LeBron and his posse and all that shit. So we know how Phil gets down. He's just one of those guys. And be gone, Phil. Be gone.
Yeah, fuck you, Phil.
For sure.
You won your championships off the backs of blacks.
Mm-hmm.
And all of a sudden, you want to take the league and flip it, dog. Fuck out of here, dog.
I mean, shit. Phil can coach, but Phil only wanted to coach the best. Like, so he coached Mike.
Exactly.
Coach Kobe and Shaq. Without them, though, nothing.
Usher reveals he wants to headline a Super Bowl halftime show. Do we want it?
I'm for it because he's an entertainer.
I want it. Well, Ursh, whatever you want to call him.
He's an
the way that,
and bring that skating shit too.
Exactly. Bring the skating ring to the goddamn stadium. Bring it to there.
And he fuck with a whole fuck with him, it seems like. So Hov, he definitely gotta get Usher.
He is a safe pick. He has
very hit. Safe.
He crosses over for everybody. He has a lot of hits, a lot of slaps that he can give you.
He can do that.
Rihanna
shit.
Gave us what? She gave us the longest one of all time. What was it, like 23 minutes? Which flipped the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
But if he can give us one of them 15 to 20 minute performances.
But he has that, though. He has that bag.
He not without a doubt.
He has that bag.
Without a doubt. So here's the thing. And this is a little.
Chris Brown or Usher?
Usher.
Okay.
And what? Well, hold on.
Whatever you want
to. Okay, I'm about to talk about it. So I watch Big Boy in the Neighborhood. I follow a lot of radio hosts and podcasters because I study them. So I'm watching Big Boy interview Usher, and I follow JD and Brian Michael Cox. Usher's album was before COVID. He was recording. It was supposed to be called Confessions 2. He did say that by the end of the year, you will get the album, and I got to put this in the group chat. It's so he did, he does his residency, but he's doing some shit in Paris, a night with Usher, and it's 4 nights. Hard. That's some shit you take your lady to. That's listen.
I want to do that Usher shit in Vegas.
If you take no,
that
you
shit
take,
was dope because he if, had that shit during the fight.
If
so
you
I know
take your
late.
Lady to Paris to see Usher, she should give you a threesome with any bitch you choose.
God damn, straight to threesome. Hey.
Like, listen, you show up, get your pussy ate. That's it. I got the rest.
It's the brothels over there, right?
They hell yeah. They there. Yeah. My boy got highlight skills. Skill. But so the album's supposed to be called Confessions 2. He never said what the album name was. But he did say it would be here by the end of the year. He also said that they had a talk about a Chris Brown Usher versus, and it's been more than one talk. He said he is open to it, but even though it would be a versus, he doesn't want it to be a versus because he loves Chris, and Chris is his little brother, but he also know that that is his competition, and they both have something to show
and
the world.
And it's crazy how far their eras are.
But how close they are together.
How close they are together.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. And the only thing I can say that really kind of differentiates them is Chris, even though Chris has writers like Usher does, I think, in my opinion, Chris does more writing than Usher does.
He probably does. And Chris can rap.
And that I mean, without being said, like, I mean, you we
that fan of a fan and all that
ooh,
shit, like,
ooh, and the mixtapes, the OFB, whatever that his little rap crew was, them boys, yeah,
the little Virginia boys,
yeah. So, I think in Chris Brown, Usher versus,
Because they're the only two that can go against one another.
I think it could possibly be bigger than Diddy Puff. I think it could be.
Probably so.
And I ain't even going to hold you. You could have that shit at the Coliseum in California. You could do. And also, not to go back, but Swiss Beatz said he wants to go back and do the battles that happened during COVID that you was in the basement and it didn't get its proper due.
Probably the joint...
I want to see Jagged Edge 112 again.
Even who did Eve win against? Because like Eve was in Trina. Trina.
I'm good on that though.
Because like Trina, like
I don't want to see Manny Fresh versus Scott Storey because he smoked him like a cheap bag of weed.
That shit happened because
you know it.
We know Manny
beats sound the same.
All the same, and I mean His hits are only at that level.
It was only
Cash Money. Like, so he was locked in with Cash Money, so he couldn't do anything outside.
Wow, they traded the pick. Okay. Stay woke. All right. Female realtors in 2023. So I'll be looking at houses just like you, but I'll be looking at them shits on Instagram. And I've seen women, black women more notably. Trying to show houses and all you see more of is ass and titties than the house. And I'm like, what am I, why are you doing a walk-off in the house? I want to see the appliances. It show me the marble countertops. Like, show me the motherfucking, the doorless shower, the motherfucking, like, the barn door in the bathroom. Like, show me this. I don't want to see your body. Like, ladies, I get it. We got to do better.
Shout out to my female realtors. Shout out my girl Zinga Zing. Shout out to my homie LaPrey. Y'all out here getting that money selling them houses.
Now, showing your body going to get you likes, but it's not going to sell the house. I don't think, or at least I don't think anyway. I'm not buying a house because you look good in it.
I don't think so. Because, I mean, especially when it comes to
a house?
A couple. Especially when it comes to. Because, I mean, because I'm sure the wife going to be looking at everything funnels through me.
Yeah.
Like, I don't need you to call my husband.
Yeah.
Talking about no garages. And every time I see you, you got a thong. I can see your thong on or your titties and popping out your shirt and shit. So. All
right, man. Closing thoughts, man. You ready to get out of here? What you got?
Man, we were like 3 weeks in from our vacation. I still ain't had a great one yet.
Come on, man. You ain't got one.
Nah, I don't, man. Shit, stay safe. Stay positive. Be yourself. Don't be no one else. There's only one you.
Mine is you're braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. On that note, this is JFP. We are potting as the draft is going on. Happy Saturday, Sunday, Monday, whenever you listen to this. Listen, like, share, comment, subscribe on YouTube. We on anywhere you stream this from, Apple Podcasts. It's on Patreon too for free. And
talking about the videos.
Oh, listen, videos. If you want to watch us here in color, HD, 4K, all this shit, go to YouTube. I will no longer upload videos to Spotify. Y'all begged and begged and begged for YouTube.
Sorry, Jay.
Take your ass to YouTube to see us. I will no longer upload any other video anywhere else. YouTube only. So if you want to watch us, go to YouTube or also go to the Patreon.
Hit the like button.
Hit the like button. Like, share, comment, subscribe. Share with somebody. I'm telling you, the laughs and jokes and the banter. If you got something you want to talk about, send it our way.
Yep.
I will throw it in the mix. On that note, listen, check this out. We're going to close this out with some Jordan Lucas in the future, man. Let's get it.
Turn the radios up. We out. I can't hide my pain no more, this shit gon' make me lash out. I ain't playing games no more, I really might just black out. She can't feel her legs no more, I blew her fucking back out. Run up on me, bitch, on God, I blow your fucking back out. Where I'm from, this shit go down, a lot of niggas crash out. I just seen my cousin cut some work about the crack house. He ain't got nothing to lose, he might just bring the mask out. He gon' take your visa too, I hope your credit card don't max out. Watch me take some bricks of soap and turn it to a bankroll. You two won't get rich like Hov until I met your peso. Billionaire advice, that's that shit that you can't
dough. One day I'ma change everything, I swear.
Like a kilo drop inside the pot, my nigga spinning. Hey, I just heard a hater just got shot, now I'm grinning. Hey, I just took more dope, that's just gonna keep me out my feelings. If I wasn't rapping, I'd be trapping, making millions. Ain't worried about nothing, I got more money than my ex. I don't have to call, bitch, pulling up off my text. First day I bought her the AP, cause she wet. I done spent so much money on bitches, I forget. One on one spill, you can't find us in a store. Heard it was your wifey, I turned her to my whore. Let me be your sponsor, you a baddie, you can get endorsed. New Chanel, you know damn well, it make girls get moist. Whipped up in a Maybach and I came back in a rust. I'ma pop my shit, drop a brick in a pack. Shorty can't complain, bitch, the whole world toxic. She belong to the street, bitch, gon' fuck on everybody.
I got coke plugs, got bass plugs, and I think I'm Pablo. This rap shit never worked out, then I'll be El Chavo. Got a stash spot for the cash drops and a blacked out Tahoe. Put a ton of cash in a duffel bag, shit that the Cabo. If my phone ring and I'm busy, I'ma just straight ignore it. If you ain't calling about money, then the shit ain't important. I used to want me a good girl, but they way too boring. Baby, we can fuck, but you can't stay till morning. If I wasn't rapping, I'd be trapping, making M's. 20 SUVs, you never know which one I'm in. Travel across the country, selling drugs to all your friends. And if I lose it all, then I just do it all again. I still got big connects, I can hit the rack from a bag of phone. If a nigga ever fall off, then I'd be Al Capone. Couple bad bitches in the kitchen, naked, they counting O's. I got niggas crossing the border for me, who down to go? I need to know.
Welcome to the Jay and Friends Podcast.